unmute button there, and then hit this.
As they're firing and make it happen!
That'd be good. There we go. Alright, everything's on. So I'll just get stuff going. I'm going to be doing a darker painting for the starter, so it'll be a little oil here. I'm going to try to do it on the palette this time. Before I did it with I just put it straight on the canvas. I'm going to try to put it on the palette first. All folks are loading in. Just putting that oil, linseed oil in here. Let's see, that works okay. That's not bad. I already sprayed the back with the water, so it should be kind of a little tight. It's very hot out, so my canvases tend to not stay tight for long. When it's really hot, they don't remain their tightness. They get really loose, even after I spray them with water. But hopefully today they do okay. Just going around the edges first and then working it. Hoping if I do it this way, instead of before where I drip it on straight on the canvas, I'll end up with less oil overall, but I don't know if it'll work. Two or three brushfuls of it to coat the whole canvas. Not full, but taps on the oil. If I dunked this thing in the oil, the whole canvas would be soaked and wouldn't be able to paint on it. But yeah, three dropperfuls of oil onto the palette and then put up here. Also makes my brush really slippery because it drips onto it. Shiny. I'm also going to change the angle of this light a little bit here. A little bit more that way. I feel like I need another light on my left side. This is low budget production here. There we go. Got that corner, got that piece. Looks good, nice and shiny, ready to paint. Hope everybody's doing well. Okay, wipe this brush off real quick. We'll be using them for a while, but we'll see how it goes. So actually do this one more time. Something like that. Okay. Colors for today. I don't know if I'll use this one, but this is raw umber, ivory black, Prussian blue, titanium white. Gonna be doing a very, I want to say monochromatic. It's not really monochromatic, but limited colors. And I wanted to paint a thunderstorm because we've been getting thunderstorms literally every day the past like 2 weeks. In the afternoons, those would be these giant, humongous pop-up storms. So that's what we'll be doing. I'm just shaking up the liquid white here. I don't think I'll need it, but just have it ready just in case. So most of this I'm going to need a mixture of black and blue. It's Prussian blue. Some of that oil gun on it, it's okay. This is all used for the background. A lot of the clouds, it's going to be mostly clouds. So I'm going to try to paint a thunderstorm. Big clouds and maybe some lightning strikes in the middle. Very low foreground, like down to here. Very, very low. Mostly clouds. Alright, let's see if we can do this. First time trying this. We'll see how it goes. Alright. Let's start by making this sky nice and dark. 2-inch brush, 2.5-inch brush. The dark color we just put mixed up. Some of these cloud lines up here and then come down the middle like this. Something like that. So it's like our big storm head there. Billy's here. Hey, Billy. Started paying when I did though. That's okay. No worries. Residual brush here in the middle. And this part right here I want to do light, so I want to put lightning in there. The rest of this has to be kind of dark, but not super dark. So if we want, we can actually start pulling this up to make it look like it's raining. Perfectly straight up, because that's not really how rain falls. It's more at an angle like that. There we go. All right, we're done. We finished the painting already. Just kidding. I'm gonna go back in one more time on this. I want this line to be really dark here. And especially up there in that top corner. Here. Some rain looking things going on there. I'm brushing off just a little bit of this here. So I don't want super dark, but I want to go over this spot one more. I want it to be kind of dark, and then I want to dark or lighten it up. Something. I might put some more dark clouds over here. I'm not really sure. We'll see once we start getting into it. Kenneth's here. Hey, Kenneth. Good afternoon. All right. So there's like our outline of these clouds. Now we gotta start putting in some colors here. We gotta make layers. So I'm gonna add some white to that. So I don't want it to be straight white yet. We're gonna save that for the big storm spot here. But a little bit of white on that, or that color, and a little bit of white. Or a lot of white and a little bit of that color. So we'll do that and then mix that up. And then we'll start putting in some layers of clouds up here where we want them to be. I think there's a big layer right here. I'm just kind of pushing around. Go up here. There's a big one right here. Goes up and around. Grab some more of that white, or that mixture color, and it'll start getting darker, so I'm gonna work that way first. These will be darker than the ones up in front. Put some back there so it's really dark, but just want some shape. I'm gonna wipe that off with the towel. Make sure we get all the dark color out. So we're gonna mix some white in. I just kind of spin it around like this until it looks like it's mostly out. That's all you really need. Go back into the white. It should be pretty white, and then we can go back into this. Now we'll be back to our starting color here. All right. So we'll start putting some down here in this area. I'll blend these out here in a second. I'm not gonna leave that color up here. We're just making layers, layers on layers. Maybe this one comes more straight across. It's probably really bad for the brush. I like the texture it makes. Probably good enough, and I'll start blending is the word before we get too into it. Where's my dark brush here? Try and wipe as much off as I can. The white's pretty strong, so I don't have to worry too much about it getting erased, but also, like some of these spots, like up in here, those look really nice, so I don't really want to mess this up too much. Just some of the middle ones. I'm going to get fuzzed out, especially up in here. Mm-hmm. There we go. Stormy sky there. All right, now we're going to blast in some very bright color here. Doing our bravery test a little early. This is our, this is the part where we punch it. I think I said it was going to be right here. Let's see, there's a bright spot there, a bright spot there, so let's do it halfway. Throwing in a blob of white. And then I'm going to start bringing it down. I just need like an aura of white here. Lightning doesn't really strike in there. There are a couple of bolts that go straight down, but a lot of it's just kind of misdirected up in the sky. Maybe it comes over here. Then there'll be some residuals, especially up on these clouds right here. Stray one that comes up here. And we'll highlight, well, not highlight, but we'll throw in some actual bright whites here with the script liner. These are just like the background. Trying to get it nice and bright. I don't even want to mess with that. I already like it. One's going to be this one right here. So that one's going to be really bright, and then these other ones will be kind of dim. So we got our nice bright background here. I might blend out some of this edge, just a touch. I don't want it to be so harsh, but yeah, something like that. That's nice. That's nice. Okay. There's our big. Do we want it to come down more? I feel like it should come down more. Maybe we'll do that. Maybe we'll just make it go all the way. Like one of those lightning strikes that shakes your whole house. Something like that. Maybe a little one. A little one comes down. Yeah. I did that because I don't really know what I'm going to put down there. I just know maybe down here we'll put some dirt or something. Maybe a power line or something, I don't know. Middle of Texas somewhere. Oklahoma. Okay. I think that's good enough for the background. And then we can do some of the finer details with the little script liner. And do it. Let's see. This one might be too small. I have two different sizes. I think I'll use this one. I always have two different sizes of everything. Small and a big one. At least one of each. Makes it easier to do some things. Different effects and whatnot. Alright. So I'm going to put some small amount of oil in the white here. And these are going to be kind of like trees, but the opposite direction. Try and soak up as much white as I can. If I had my thin white or my magic white out, I could use that instead. But I don't have it. I didn't have the lid unscrewed, so could use it on the next one maybe. All right, let's get this. We don't want a huge sloppy amount of that. I don't want it dripping everywhere. That should be good. All right. Which one do we start? I kind of usually start with the edges. This might be easier if I flip the canvas upside down. But let's start here. Like I paint tree branches. This is probably not the right way to do it, but I don't know. Maybe it'll look okay. There's probably a better tutorial somewhere on how to paint lightning bolts. But I'm just painting them. Painting them this way. Kind of trying to jiggle. Jiggle back and forth, left and right, make it look really jagged. Alright, there's those two. There's a little tiny one that comes over here. Just like that. Alright, what's the next one? Got this big one up here. Maybe he comes down like that. And then another branch. Or these aren't branches. I don't know what you call them. Bolt. Mini bolt. Baby bolt. Let's see. That looks more like a cloud. I don't like that. Kind of hard to do them from the side, but we'll make do. Oh, that works really well. I just kind of held it like this and then pulled. How's that look? It's hard to tell. On the screen, it looks better than it does to my eyes up here. It's just TV magic. Elvis, Nader. Hey, Elvis, how's it going? Good to see you. Good to see everybody here. We're painting storms today. So we've been getting nonstop storms this past week. 2 weeks, really. Could add a tornado, but that might be too aggressive. I don't even know if you put the tornado back here. This one. I do want to blend out that spot here. Do we want one to come out of the top? I feel like we should. Oh, we did draw some of those, so maybe I'll do that next. after I finish up this spot right here. I want him to go up. Yeah, just like that. Just like that. Alright, let's make him, let's do these ones next. So we did draw in some that were gonna go this way, so let's knock those out. This one comes back down. And we got one more up here. He goes right there. Cool. He comes down. We might have little baby bolts, I think we call them. Tiny bolts here. This one has to be a little bit bigger. There. Something like that. How's that looking? Did they ever go vertical? I don't know if I've ever seen one go like straight up. Who knows? I'm not a meteorologist. Here, I'm just gonna blend out some of these spots here. Add in some little stray baby bolts here and there. Maybe one up here. Looks like he's connecting these two. This is pretty much like how I paint tree branches if I was doing a big old tree. So I don't paint too many of those, but I think this is okay. Although I would like to connect one to this cloud up here. Maybe we'll do that. There we go. Looks like he's hitting that spot right there, making it bright. Well, that was fun. Hello, Michael's here. Michael Kuster from Germany. That's cool. Been getting a lot of folks from all over tuning in. Had one from Saudi Arabia the other day left a comment. Got Germany, some people from France. All over the United States, people are tuning in. Pretty crazy. Never thought that my little YouTube stream would turn into an international thing people watch, but that's pretty cool. It's very exciting. All right, do we want to put in the ground now? Let's do that. And I don't know what, I really don't know what to do with the ground, to be honest. It's just a flat brush. Kind of something to be here. I don't really want to put anything in though. Now they look like little hills. There's a lot of oil down here, so it's going to be slick. There we go. There's a little bigger one right there. And one over here. And one even bigger one right there. There, that's better. That would look weird. Let's make it look like there's a road coming through here. I think I will throw in a power line or something along the side. We'll see if we can do that. That might look okay. Outline of the road. I'm gonna put in some power lines here. Could make it look like a field too, but I don't know. I don't really know what we want to do here. Still thinking. Alright, let's get some of that white. Bluish, dark blue color. Alright. Start in the back. Won't be able to see them until they get up close. Make sure I'm just kind of straight here. Not super straight, but straight enough. All right, what do power lines look like? Got these big trunks. Or what are they? I don't even know what they're called. It's usually a big trunk and then a sideways thing. Two sideways things. Probably should have made the background not so dark. This would have looked better. Oh well. Let's make a little bit of a lighter color. Let's tap it. Tap it. There we go. Could use a really small one here, but set of power lines running out here. And he drifts off into the distance. They don't have to be perfect, especially over here. They don't matter so much. I do want to tap it one more time with the white. Maybe I can get a little bit. Yeah, there we go. Just a little bit brighter. Especially with all this lightning going on, you know. That way you can actually see them. Okay. Do they run on both sides? I don't even know. Thank you. pretty dark too. Our storm. Does it look okay? Does it look like a storm? Some power lines, maybe. I don't know. Well, I didn't get any naphthol red out, so can't sign with that. Maybe we'll sign with just white. This should be okay. Just gotta make sure my brush is cleaned up first. Put the year. 2, 3. That's fun. A little different. Different painting. Learn new things. Try new things. Alright. Let's take it down and hopefully not knock it off the... Stormy painting. Alright. Put this back here. Clean up, get ready for the next one. This might be one of my favorite ones. I really like the lightning bolts there. Okay. Wipe stuff off and get ready for the next one. I don't really have any ideas for the next one. I was just looking at pictures of the Dolomites in Italy. Or wherever they are. I don't know if they're actually in Italy. There we go. Maybe we can just do a nice little mountain painting. Elvis, love it. Thanks, Elvis. Glad you enjoyed it. Maybe learn something, maybe not. That's okay. I learned some stuff. Learned how to do lightning bolts. Alright. Let's figure out what colors we want to use for this next one. So we didn't really use the umber that I thought I was going to use. Which is okay. Got a bunch of Prussian blue left. And a good bit of white. Let's see. I want to do a bright painting. Maybe. Maybe. Let's do a little bright painting here. Oh, that one was pretty dark, so I need to lighten the mood. Oh, I got paint all over my hands. I didn't even use that many colors. What the heck? Oh well. Down some burnt sienna. One of my favorite colors. So I'm using crimson. Crimson's always fun. I don't know why it's so hot up here. I have the AC running. This still feels like it's 80 degrees. Must be just the heat. Summer heat. Okay. Let's put some white down. I always use more white than I think I will. Okay. I'll get some yellows in here. Some reds. Naphthol red. Someday I have to do a yellow, red, and blue painting. Work on my color mixing abilities. Because I'm not very good at it yet. Still trying to figure out colors in general. Especially when I get them mixed up and I get frustrated. It happens all the time. Let's get some yellow gray. Okay. Cad yellow, white, yellow ochre. Probably not any Indian yellow. I don't know. Maybe Indian yellow. I can't decide. Let's not use emerald green this time. I feel like I rely on emerald green too much, so I'm trying not to use it. We'll make our own color with cad yellow and blue. Alright. Paul. Hey, Nate. Hello, Paul. How's it going? Good to see ya. Just getting started on the second one. Let's do some mountains. I haven't done like a big mountain one in a long time. Could do it with all the palette knife, but I don't know. I don't know if I'm prepared. First thing, we'll need a canvas. I always forget. Put up my canvas. Here we go. Spray the back with water. By the time I'm ready, it'll be tightened up. Hopefully. My space is also a lot tighter, so because this easel is so huge. Shall we? Oh, I gotta hit a button. Let's hit the red button this time. Or no, I already hit that one.
Is it firing and make it happen?
Need some Bill Alexander energy. Okay, this I think already shook up, so let's pop this open. This is what I've been using for thin white. And let's get started. Hopefully we don't knock the canvas over. There we go. I think that should be enough here. As long as I have big spots in between it. Canvas. If you have like a quadruple prime canvas, you don't have to push nearly as hard. Mine's only, these ones are double prime, so I have to kind of push pretty hard to get it in between the weaves. Stretch the arm out in between. Just kidding. It's not that bad. Okay. That's good. Here. Oh, that's a huge spot up here. Holy cow. Alright, if we're going to do a big old mountain range, sketch we got. I'll always do a sketch, because if I don't, I go a little haywire. Go off the rails. And ends up looking like a big old blob. So, let's do a little sketch here once we get the colors. After I splatter paint all over my foot. I just wipe off my, whatever brush I use to put the liquid white on, or thin white. I always clean it after the painting, because I know I'm not going to use it again. So that's just what I'm doing here. There we go. Okay. Get that hair over here. All right. Colors that we're going to use for this one. This is leftover from the last one. I don't know if I'll actually use it, but this is raw umber, burnt sienna, ivory black, Prussian blue, alizarin crimson, titanium white, cadmium light, yellow ochre, naphthol red. Let's do a nice painting here. Start with the Prussian blue. Although I did say I was gonna do a sketch before I turn into a mess. So let's do the sketch first. Could do it with blue. Maybe that, blue would probably just get nuked away. So let's see. Decision. Just make it. Big mountains. Big sharp mountains here. Something like this. Maybe there's another little peak here. Okay, we got two blobs. Let's have another little blob back here. This one will be farther away. I'm just kind of sketching it in like it's not that far away, but I want this one to be the farthest away. So we'll do this side first. It comes back into here. Well, maybe he's got another peak up there. But again, very far away. So we won't really be able to see him. All right. In the front, I don't know. What do we do in the front? Trees? I like trees. I want to do a big tree line. Trees. And then, do we do another set of trees over there on the left? Maybe. Maybe they're just not as big. Something like that. Maybe there's a little channel of water here. Big trees. There's our sketch. If you can call it that. It's more like a bunch of scribbles. But something to start with. So Nate, with the water oils, you don't have to mix them. Just wash with water. I'm not sure what you mean by mix, but you can wash them with just water, but it's usually better to use soap and water, otherwise they'll like, I don't have a brush here that I've used recently, or maybe I do, I use this one, yeah, so this one I used a long time ago with water mixable, and I just washed it with water, because at the time that's what I was doing, and it has residual, it doesn't hurt anything, but you can still see there's a color in there. It'll go away when you start painting with another color, but just something, if you don't use soap, that's usually what happens. Just for the longest time, I did not use any soap in my water mixable oil cleanup. You don't have to mix with water. Correct. Yeah. No, they're just like regular oil paints. So these are regular oil paints, but yeah, they function the same way. You paint with them like you normally would, and only when you're done, that's when you use the water. Wash them off. I'm going to try not use much pressure here. seems all pretty good. I gotta go. See you next week. No worries, Paul. Thanks for stopping by. Okay, there's our big old sky. Let's throw in some clouds. Let's use the, I didn't wipe it off, but I don't think I really need to. This is a filbert brush. We'll just do some filbert clouds today. I like doing them in that last painting, so I want to do them again. These are kind of easy, just do little circles here. I want the clouds to be, I'm already kind of messing it up. I want to be on the right side. That's where the highlight's going to be. I'm just throwing some color in for now. As I go towards the bottom, I don't want it to be as bright. So. Right, let's do one more up here. This one can just go up until the top, just like that. Then we'll fuzz them out. All right, let's blend up some of this guy here. Let's keep going with the filbert. I mean, it works pretty good for this step. Tricky one because there's so much paint there that I put down. I don't want to go into that other cloud. Oh, we already, we're drifting into him. That's okay. Using the bigger brushes, I think, works better for this, but really it's just personal preference. Whatever you like more. Okay. So there's our big sky and big clouds. Let's work in our little mountains. I guess these are gonna be pretty big. All right, I could do these with the, let's keep going with the filbert, but I'll do them old school. I say old school, this is the way I used to do them. I still do them most of the time like this, but. Crimson, Prussian blue, permanent crimson. Very strong crimson. So you don't need nearly as much of it as you would regular Elizabeth crimson. At least this type, this brand. Can't speak to the other ones. Alright, let's get some white here. We're going to do the faraway ones first, then work forward. My neighbor's dog is barking. Here. Should have mixed up more of that, but that's okay. I think there was one up here. So I'll throw that one in. I just mean kind of getting in there and shaking my palette knife around. Background one. All right, we said the light is on the right side. So let's do that first. In a long time. Hopefully it comes out okay. A little bit of that. This color for the shadow. These ones are far away. I don't want to be super bright on the highlights. That's way too much. That's not enough. I'll get it, I swear. Okay. That's good enough. That's what I can work with. There's a hair in there. That's no good. Try not to sneeze. Keep working it down the mountain. Maybe we'll do this one next because he's a little bit bigger. Maybe we'll just connect all these. Why not? Slightly darker color together. Maybe we'll take the rest of that and add that to the white, the remaining white that we have here. Hopefully that's not the same color. Might be. We'll just keep rolling with it. That should be fine. It's the faraway mountain anyway. Hoping it's slightly darker than, or slightly lighter than the background, but I don't think it is. Maybe it is, I don't know. Okay. There's our background. We'll do our foreground mountain over here. I just use the straight color here. Alright, we said it was going to be like this big, so we'll just go in, start throwing it in. Wherever our peaks are. Oh, I didn't mash in that side. No, I forgot to do something. It's been too long. Some mist in there first. There we go. All right, back to this. Now I can pull it in front. Like so. Whoops, almost jabbed a hole in the canvas there. Let's pull that one back a little bit and see how that one. This one, you can come up there, like so. There, there, and there. And this part, I mean, the main focus, everyone always says, is the top edge. So as long as you got a reasonable top edge, you'll be okay. There. This one looks too much like a triangle. I don't like it. I don't like triangles. Just made another triangle. That's okay. All right, you can use a 1-inch here, but I'm gonna use it. The old reliable 2.5-inch brush. Going to be land, so I'm not worried about it. Out of paper towels here. Your rocks always look exceptionally realistic. Thanks, Kevin. That's a lot of practice there. Still have room to grow, but I thank you for the encouragement. I do get lots of comments that always cheer me up. People liking the streams and stuff. Makes me want to keep practicing, getting better. So I really do appreciate it. And it helps me ignore the bad comments when I get the good ones. Because I want to use it to pat the bottom. Although, if we are going to do something, we can make it look like water. Water that's the same color as the mountains in here. Might as well do it now while I still got the color on the brush, you know. No sense in wasting it. Ready to go for the next step, highlighting the old rocks. And these ones are going to be bright because they're closer, so they should be brighter than those. That's my only goal here, is to make some rocks that are color that is brighter than those. Maybe it has a little bit of the, what's that, purple color? I don't know. Just a little bit. That's way too much, but we can work with it. We can work with that. Pressure trick. Well, you really need a sticky paint to be able to do it like this. Otherwise, it'll just kind of paint be sliding all over. Won't make you happy. Spot here. Choose a triangle. I don't like triangles, which I've said. Even though I got triangles all up and down this thing. There. Now let's just use Prussian blue straight up. And there is some red in there, but just a very small amount. Use that in the shadow sides up in here. Make sure we get it in that crevice here. Especially up here. I don't want that blind spot. And then down along here. Make it look cold. Some shadows in between. Okay. Now let's go and tap the bottoms here. Hopefully not knock anything over. There's our mountains, plural, hanging out. Now we gotta do we'll do a little foreground here. I think we said there's gonna be a little one here and one over there, so let's do that. What are we gonna use? I mean, we could use might as well just use the 2-inch brush here. I'll actually use that raw and where I said I was going to use. There's some blue in there. And a little bit of burnt sienna. Alright, let's start. Oh, it just looks kind of like sand. But not until you get to the shore. So it'll be nice and dark. Right up until the corner. Or the front. There we go. Do the same over on this other side. I think we said this one would be a little bit smaller, so. Just gotta make sure this is actually a triangle. Or a triangle shaped. Just has to line up there. Pull it down a little bit. At least while I got the color on there. So it looks like there's a reflection. straighten stuff up when I do that. Sorry if I whistled there. All right. I'm gonna add some pine trees, maybe? I don't know. Any tree will do. Could add a cabin as well. All right, let's keep going with these colors. Red sienna is good, and a little bit of crimson in there is good too. Maybe a little bit of black. To be like a dark brown. Okay. Start throwing in some of these trees. We can do, maybe we'll do some of these first. You know, this type of tree. And then on top of this, we'll throw in some bigger trees. Turn the brush sideways as I get more to this side. There we go. And do the same over here. And this one, I don't know if I'll actually highlight or make any bigger trees. This side I will. Alright, let's make some bigger trees here. A little bit more of that color. Black, burnt sienna, crimson. Could add a little bit of blue. Let's start with these. Some more, might as well. Maybe do a little one over here, a little baby one. Baby tree, there we go. That's a nice one. All right, no, I said I wasn't gonna do one over there, but I'm gonna do one. We'll be alone. Or maybe he's not alone, he's got little friends around him. He's just bigger. Something like that. Then we can reflect these down into the water. Like that. Like that. And like that. They don't have to be perfect. They can be blobs. That's fine too. Blobs are okay when you're painting. If you like painting blobs, then just paint blobs. No rule that says you have to paint anything that looks like anything. Just do whatever you want. Alright, this brush is cleaned up. A little fan brush. I do have another one I could use to use highlights, but I like using the same brush over and over sometimes. Very gentle. A little less gentle over there. Okay. I'll do some highlights on the trees. Maybe use some of our yellows that we've been saving. Let's use yellow ochre. That's usually a nice highlighting color. Some, not crimson. What do you want to add in there? Burnt sienna? That's pretty good. And a little tiny bit of blue. That's a lot of blue. That's a nice, that's okay color. Let me lighten it up just a touch. Okay. I'll come in and highlight the right sides here. Just kind of touch. I'm going to do two highlights. So we'll do this one first. And then I'll come in with a very bright color here. Don't forget the water. You can always touch these up. And I'll do both of those first before I pull the water highlights up. Okay. So I didn't clean the brush very much, but it should be enough of that yellow in there to darken this cad yellow to a point where it's not ridiculous. By ridiculous, I just mean like super strong, because cad yellow is very, very strong. Actual cad yellow is. Alright, as we work towards the back, they should get darker. So I just kind of have hits of the color in here. Same over here. Alright, now we'll pull down the water highlight. I'll be adding a rock or two. So, light, light. One, two, three. One, two, three. I could probably do both of these at the same time. There we go. Outstanding. Thanks, Elvis. Alright. Let's see. Should probably put some actual water in here instead of this weird looking ripple thing going on there. But we'll save that here for a little bit. Let's add in some grass. Some of that other green. And we'll just kind of tap them in here. I just want to brighten this up. It's too dark. I don't know. The other one was so dark, and then this one was so dark. I just wanted to lighten it up, lighten the mood here. I'm just kind of pressing in with the fan brush. Something like that. You can also pull up spots, make it look like tall grass. Whatever you want to do. Ooh, that side looks nice. There's not as much glare on this side, so I can better see what I'm doing. This side, I can't see at all. When I'm painting. Alright. I can see it when I look at the screen, so if I go and turn at the screen, that's what I'm doing. My little iPad here. That's what I have to chat up on. Very low budget stream here. I don't have a full computer, I just have a little iPad and my GoPro. It's all duct taped together. Okay, so we got mountains, trees. We do need a little bit of a shoreline in here, so I'll add that. And then once I have the shoreline in, we can add, I'm going to add in the water, because this just looks sloppy and I don't like it. And we got time to fix it, so we might as well. All right, I'm just going to use regular sienna, burnt sienna here. I'm going to not go in a straight line. I'm going to tap and then move up, tap and move up. And then once I got it in, I'm going to scrape down. So it's not like one curved line. They're kind of separated, so there's little separations. I just do that because I think it makes it look like the land's, there's more land there, more separated land, if that makes sense. Okay. All right. There's a little bit of dirt in there. Could highlight this, but I think I'm just gonna smooth it out and then add in a water line around it. That usually works just as well. So let's put in some water around these. This here. Same kind of, not really a rule, but a method here. So don't go in a straight line. Kind of put some down, lift up, put some down, lift up. That's what I found works best for me. That's way too much there. From this side. Put some down, lift up, put some down, lift up, put some down, lift up. There we go. Now we'll throw in actual water here. I'm debating whether or not to just go in with the palette knife. I think I will just use the palette knife here, so. This is the quick and dirty paint by Nate method for water. Just go in with the palette knife and scrape. Here to make them look 3D, just like that. Alright, that was fun, a little mountain painting. I don't know if it's any mountain in particular, but just felt like doing one, so that's what we got. We will take, actually I need some oil for this, naphthol red. Some thin oil here. Just a little drop. There we go. It should be dripping off. I don't know if I've ever showed this, but it should be kind of dripping there. That's what I used to sign with. Over here, over there. I think let's do it down here. When it's dripping like that, it makes it much easier to sign because it just goes over everything. Don't have to worry about it mixing. Unless you want your signature to mix, sometimes that makes for a cool effect. But it's up to you. Up to you what you want to do. 2, 3. There we go. Hope everybody enjoyed. I enjoyed having you here, folks from all over. Elvis, Kenneth, Paul. We got Michael. Billy was here earlier. Thanks everybody for stopping by. Stopping by. Alright, there we go. Okay, there's a little mountain painting. Nice and relaxing, I hope. I'll go put this down back here, and then we'll say our goodbyes until next week. So thanks everybody for tuning in. I appreciate you. I appreciate the support. Paint by Nate. We'll see you next week.